All right. I'm going to be narrating through this video. I turn my camera on every time I ride for just in case anything happens, but this time I'm specifically making a video for Tyler Jane because earlier I was going to tell her how she should do her next vlog. Tell her that I'd like to hear her thoughts while she's riding, since she's a new rider. You're only a new rider once, and what you're thinking then was when you're new, a lot different than after you've got some miles under your belt and years. And then I thought, well, I've got no business telling her what to do because I'm in the same boat. I should be doing the same thing. As far as I can see, she's riding at least as well as I am, and probably better after only a week. So I will do this vlog the way I was expecting her to, or going to ask her to, which is just to put your thoughts out there's what you're thinking, little details of what goes through your mind while you're feeling your way through the learning experience. But I think we possibly were both past that. The really beginner stuff. But I find myself still having to concentrate on the most trivial things. I think should be second nature by now. I've started some bad habits, and now I find myself having to concentrate to break them. You might notice everything's all wet around here. I wasn't able to ride this morning because a big storm came through. And that didn't ruin my day, but when it's time to go home and I had to get in the car instead of on the bike, that sucked. So I've been looking forward to getting it out ever since. Done with dinner. Still got some sun left. So now I get to practice what I was going to preach. It's only right. And I think somebody told Jane to her last video was too long. And I'm thinking, no way. I watched it this morning and I was thinking the same thing when I turned it on. I said, 30 minutes, I don't have that much time before I gotta get to work. I ended up watching 25 minutes of it. I couldn't watch the last. I had to skim through the last five and enjoyed every bit of it. I will try to. I'd like to cut mine shorter, but I don't want anybody to think that I cut out the parts where I fell down or rode in front of a car or anything like that. That's the exact kind of stuff I will leave in, absolutely. So right now what's going through my mind is I don't want to stop in the middle of this big puddle up here. Oh my God, it's muddy. I'm having trouble feathering the speed with the clutch. You know, riding slow like that is better to, here's where I can tip it over. keep the RPMs up and just use the clutch for moving. That's tough. Oh gosh. So going through my mind now is I'd really, really like to get shifting a lot smoother. I got in the habit of just dumping the clutch. Just dump it, because it really doesn't matter. I don't think it's hurting anything. Another habit, I'm putting my foot down. Kind of thing you shouldn't have to be thinking about after a whole month of riding. I've got my sheet, 775 miles. Should not have to think about any of this ever. So I hose myself. If the traffic would have been clear, I think I would have coasted right through again. Consciously thinking about letting the clutch out smooth, slow. Somebody learning to drive back there. For making a nice smooth shift. That's terrible. If I'd have been doing it right in the first place, I wouldn't have to think about it right now. You just notice my left hand's in my lap again. There's a habit. Try to remember to turn my signal off. Success. Gotta remember the speed limit on the street's only 25. I'm going 32, 30.
all my narration is always going to be punctuated with coughs and throat clearing and like that. I've been to doctors to figure out what's wrong with respiratory. Always have congestion. I think it could be asthma, stuff like that. Been to GPs. Ear, nose, and throat, pulmonary specialists. I think they just pass you around from one friend to another to keep lining each other's pockets. I've always said, if your mechanic didn't do any better than your doctor, you'd sue him. You wouldn't pay him. Nice downshift, nice and smooth, oh brother. Doctors get paid no matter what they don't accomplish. Just keep here, try this pill, come back in a month, take this test, come back in another month. Then they send x-rays out to other people to read them and get paid for them. Your insurance pays for it, but it's BS. See if I can downshift nicely. I'm willing to bet not one person in this complex stops for that stop sign. But I'm gonna do it because I gotta get some good habits going. Better. Oh, they stopped. How do you like that? This is Lakeland Community College in Willoughby, Ohio. Up here is where I took the, I think I can go around this way. The safety course. That was finished it about 9 days ago. So they got the pavement all marked out for the tests. I think they call it a U-turn test, or I don't know what, I'm not sure. But I had that down really well. Here's a box. You stay within this box right here. And wouldn't you know it, when it came time to actually do the test, I pooched it some. I don't know why. It's ridiculous. Because I think I was doing this better than anybody. Oh, there we go. This is kind of what I did. I went outside. So I lost 3 points for that. This is where you have to keep the RPMs up a little bit. Feather the clutch. Use the rear brake to, I think it's going a little too quick. If you go too slow, you have to pick it up a little bit. Anyway, I had this down pretty good. I'm not worried about this. I'd like to get better at it. I'd like to get really good. I'm really impressed with, I was watching a cop's motorcycle rodeo. It's just amazing. Love it. That and Gymkhana, the moto Gymkhana. I guess I don't know if they think they mostly do that in Japan, but it is just really impressive. I love that. I love to have that kind of control of a bike. But the quick stops is still giving me trouble. Supposed to get up to about 15 miles an hour in second gear. See if we can line up for it somewhere. Pick a spot to stop. I'm gonna start my stop, but that okay, stopped well. Used the rear, even slid the rear brake a little. Did not get it into first gear. How hard is that? I don't know. I just can't seem to do it. I did it. I get a star. Do you lose points for sliding the back brake? Maybe, I'm not sure. I did it, I stomped too hard again on it. Boy! Don't know about that. So now I got my right foot down and my left foot's up on the gear shift. I know that's not right. Okay, that's right. I think I made it to 15 miles an hour. God, I'm dying. It's a little warm. There. He's good. 20 more times and I'll have it. Ooh, I mean, I keep sliding the back tire, and that can't be good. Can't be right. Guess I figure I can't hurt anything if you do. Oh, well, I made it in the first, but put my right foot down. Man, I'm not happy unless I'm sliding that back tire. But I stopped. Got
Got it in the first, got the left foot down, I'm happy. I'm happy, that's cool. Maybe one of them in my future. Maybe, maybe not. I do appreciate how nimble these bikes are. Oh, here I am in fourth gear. I'm really progressing. Really getting good. About this way. One thing I told Tyler was to, you know, things start getting too confusing or start getting, you know, upset or just too excited or something like that, just to calm down, even if they have to pull over to do that, because you can't be riding in a confused state, or it's just too much to think about with, and you end up doing stupid things. And anyway, I said that yesterday coming home from work. I think I forgot. I don't pay any attention to what I say. I don't practice what I preach. Somebody a couple cars up decided to make a left turn at the light, but they decided they didn't bother to put the turn signal on, which annoyed me. I get annoyed easy. That's something I think Tyler Jane takes that stuff in stride. I just get that impression. Could be wrong, but. So when I got a chance to go around, I jumped on the throttle.
just to let them know I was annoyed, but who's that gonna hurt? If I'm not paying attention to what's down the road, I'm more concerned with letting them know how they tick me off. They're just gonna get me in trouble. In trouble or worse. Here we go, here's some fun. I'm gonna attempt to make a left. And this light never knows you're here. I put a huge magnet on my kickstand. I hear you're supposed to get on the sensor on the line here. The magnet, I don't know if you can see it down there or not. It's right mounted right to the top of the kickstand. Now that car might trip it for me. But no, not for either of us. Magnets I saw online specifically for that purpose were like $20. I think the one I got is like 2.5-3 inches by a couple inches by about an inch thick or bigger. It's not a high power magnet, but it's a big magnet just the same. I think if anything's going to trip that should be able to do it. Video's been going at this point, just a bunch of rambling. Go through here, I think about the speed limit. I'm not sure where the one city starts and another ends, but when you get into a little north of here, there's cops are pretty, they've got a couple roads to patrol. And if you're smart, you'll go the speed limit. I don't know if they come down this way or not. Not worth risking it. This, I believe, is Concord. Concord Township. I guess Chardon comes right up to this area. Some of these roads may pass through a bit of Chardon, which is surprising because Chardon, to get to the downtown Chardon, I'd have to go south of here like 4 or 5 miles. So it stretches up here pretty far. Thank you. to get in front of me. Oh, rats. I'd just as soon poke along through here. Everybody, oh, now see, we got 25 miles an hour up this way. This is, I think, where you got to start watching out. Look at him go. Yeah! This is where you should be watching for deer too. They are all over around here. Oh, nice smooth downshift. Really? See, just dump it. That's just, I am not gonna get past that. It'd be easier on my chain if I'd smooth it out. If I just concentrate on staying smooth, it would become a habit. I wouldn't think about it. Boy. I think maybe I'll go to Chardon. Very nice road to ride on. I think, let's see, 7, 8 o'clock. Shouldn't be too many people coming home from work this late. There, put my foot down. Oh, brother. I think the speed limit's about at least 45. It's a nice ride down here. I haven't been here for a couple weeks, I don't think. Cops. I think they got one. one sheriff for this entire county, I think. It might not be that bad, but it's close. Five and a half mile commute to work. I mean, that would be work. If I have to think about every muscle move. Thank you. I don't know what size the tubes are that go into the carburetor. Somebody said they were using a tube at about 176 thousandths. Leads me to believe that the tubes into the carburetor are maybe 3/16 or so. So if I get some tubing, that's the size I'll get. I'm going to stop. I'm not going to coast, which is what I would have done. Oh, yeah. Darn. Right up here. A lot of the people here fought tooth and nail against having Walmart. And now that they have a super Walmart, I don't think they're so against it anymore. Because they used to have to drive all the way out to where I'm from to get there. Ah, sport bike behind me. Standard bike. It's not. I'm in the wrong spot. Yeah. Oops. I don't get out here that often, so I can't can't remember where everything is. Getting there. Yep. Huh. What is this? Went to the wrong one again. Oh, I think it's closed. Friday, 8 o'clock, they close. It's 8:06. Good job. Well, I do know where a hardware store is, though. I doubt that hardware store is going to pass. They open that late, but play another light, I won't be able to trip. No, this is a nuisance. I don't know what you do about this. Transition shield, but it's not dark enough for that mess. When I took a driver at 40 some years ago, we had to sit through these movies, horrible crash movies, and one of them took place right up here at this intersection. I guess it's pretty bad, this particular intersection is right next to the highway patrol station, ironically. So whenever I go through here, I get to remember that video. They were graphic then. I don't know if they still show videos like that or not now, but I've mentioned anybody who will listen. this and how unpleasant it is going this speed. I don't enjoy anything about it. If I had to commute at this speed, I don't think I'd bother.